The American Heart Association creates guidelines for CPR and first aid to help healthcare providers and community members perform effective resuscitation on people in cardiac arrest. These guidelines are followed by individuals and organizations across the U.S. and the world. So where do these guidelines come from, and how are they developed? The AHA is part of the International Liaison Committee on Resuscitation, or ILCOR, and this committee reviews the latest resuscitation science. The AHA and other member councils around the world then take this evidence, review it, and create the treatment recommendations, algorithms, and programs which help you become trained in performing high-quality, life-saving CPR. To explain this process, here's Bob Newmar, chair of the American Heart Association ECC Committee and AHA delegate to ILCOR.
The science evaluation process really begins with ILCOR, which is the International Liaison Committee on Resuscitation. And this is a consortium of resuscitation councils similar to the American Heart Association across the world that brings together the world's experts in the field to evaluate the current science and then generate a consensus on science and then draft treatment recommendations using grade methodology that then is used by member councils to develop their guidelines.
Dr. Newmar, why is it so important for the AHA and these six ILCOR member councils to develop this worldwide consensus and then develop guidelines for their respective regions?
Obviously, the ultimate goal of ILCOR is for everyone who has a cardiac arrest or requires resuscitation across the world should have access to the same level of care.
That sums up the goal of the AHA, a world where no one dies of cardiac arrest. For more on this and other important issues, check out our new digital digest at heart.org/ECC digest.